The journey of success is extremely boring, okay? But whoever can stick it out the longest and hang in there and do those little simple little things the longest is going to see the most success.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
So my questions are more so for everyone who's starting out. Basically, when was it, when you first started, what was the first thing that you decided to delegate? Was the first question. Second, what's the first thing you decided to systematize in your business? And third is, what's one thing you wish you knew when you started in real estate that you didn't know, that you wish you had known from the beginning?
You want me to jump in there, Tony?
Sure, go ahead, all yours.
So when I first got into the business, as far as delegation goes, nothing. I mean, in the beginning, there's nothing. You're a brand new agent. You know, you really shouldn't delegate anything because you don't know what to delegate. You're a brand new agent. You don't know the game. You don't know how to do a contract. You don't know how to build your business. You don't know how to market yourself. You don't know anything. So the first year should literally be you learning the business so that you can then at some point in the future, try to figure out what activities that you need to delegate, right? So in the beginning, there's really no delegation. It's all learning and trying to figure it all out until you've actually, see, this is one thing for me. I didn't hire an assistant until way past the point that I needed an assistant. Like I should have hired an assistant way before I did. But the thing was, is I wanted to continue to do everything on my own as long as I could, because I wanted to know the business inside and out. Because if I didn't know the business inside and out, I wouldn't know what to delegate. I wouldn't. And if I tell someone to do something, but I don't know how to do it, then we're really kind of going backwards, you know? So, and the first system that I put in place, the first real system I put in place was when I came back from the market. I did the same thing, but when I lost everything, before I lost everything in the crash, my system was literally direct mail. Like I would send letters and postcards to owners. And because the market was exploding so much and prices were going up so high, those letters attracted attention and I got deals from that. That was kind of my system before I lost everything. And then when I came back, of course, I created the system of the weekly email, right? And so that turned into my system when I got back in the business. And then what was your third question?
And what's the one thing you wish you knew when you first started?
Oh my gosh, man, where do I begin with that? I think that what the most important thing that I wish I would have known is that your prospects and deals and everything else is you need to treat everyone like their family and not care if they buy or sell today. I wish someone would have told me that from day one and made me understand that it's about treating people like family and not caring if they buy or sell today or not, and then building my database. Because if I would have known that, then I would have never lost everything. I would have just continued selling properties through the crash, and I would have just continued to do better and better instead of losing everything, going bankrupt, sleeping in my car. So that's the biggest part of advice. And beyond that, talk to the most people. I want you to outwork every agent in your market. You know, that's what I want you to do. I want you to find the number one agent in your market. I want you to watch what they do. And then I want you to do more than them. Okay, what I want you to do is I want you to find the number one agent in the market, the top agent. If you guys want to be the number one agent in your market, okay, I was the number one RE/MAX agent in Alabama 3 different years. And what I did was I found the number one guy in the state and I looked to see what he was doing. And I said, I can do that, right? What the actions and activities that successful people do is not really, it's not super complicated. It's not extremely hard. The hard part is that the activities that create success are routine. They're the same activities every day, day in and day out for years and years and years. And most people can't deal with how boring that is, doing the same stuff every day. Most people they can't deal with how boring that success, the journey of success is extremely boring, okay? But whoever can stick it out the longest and hang in there and do those little simple little things the longest is gonna see the most success, you know what I mean?